Scary Sixes Monster Mash!
Halloween 2018.
What's up, folks? I just got out of the movie theater and saw the new Halloween. What can I say, but it was a masterpiece. I really thoroughly enjoyed it. There was so many homages to all the other films. It was like, yeah, they're ignoring everything after the original Halloween, but they totally had a bunch of homages to a lot of the other films in the franchise. When I saw the opening credit scene and it was just like the original Halloween opening, I was immediately sold. Really great camera work. John Carpenter actually came back and did the score, the musical score again for it. And folks, the music in this movie was so good. The timing of the music, everything was perfect. I am literally blown away. The crowd was actually, in certain parts, they were literally clapping because the movie just delivered so well. It was really nice to see Jamie Lee Curtis in it again, especially at her old age that she is. She was really badass. I just really feel like it was a huge love letter to the franchise. They really did go above and beyond to make this film great. Like I said, there was a lot of homages and nods to the previous films, even though they don't really exist, quote unquote, anymore. Like, they had these kids wearing silver shamrock masks. Michael Myers literally nailed a guy to the wall, just like in the first one. The cinematography alone was amazing. Like, the over-the-shoulder camera work for when Michael's walking and the camera's like literally following right behind him. It was totally reminiscent of Halloween 2, and I really love how they did that. Michael Myers literally crushed this dude's head by stomping on it. Oh man. He literally kills this one guy and turns him into a human jack-o'-lantern. Michael even kills a kid in this movie. He doesn't give a fuck. The movie basically starts off with these two reporters, I guess you would say, and they have been covering like unsolved mysteries and murders and all this shit for years, and they thought it would be a good idea to cover the whole Michael Myers Haddonfield scandal. So they go to Smith's Grove and the guy pulls the mask out and you see the mask again for the first time, you know. And he's literally like screaming at Michael, say something, you know, and Michael's not saying anything. And there's a bunch of crazy people out there in the yard with Michael Myers like freaking out. And there's like a siren going off. It just gave you that really nervous, tense feeling. It was really awesome. And just whenever the news reporters or journalists or whatever start to get too close to Michael and figure out a little bit too much, he just kills the shit out their asses. He literally beats the hell out of a mechanic and takes the jumpsuit from him. After he kills the two reporters or whatever, he goes out to their car and he pops the trunk and finds his mask. And let me tell you something, folks, when he put the mask on, people were literally clapping in the audience. It was such an iconic scene. Holy shit. You have to see it for yourself. There's really nothing that I don't like about the movie except for like a couple of pointless scenes. Like there was a scene where these two cops were talking about what they were going to eat for lunch or some shit in the car. But I mean, other than that, the whole movie, like I said, the cinematography, the actors, the actresses, the way that Michael Myers was old, all these elements just made a really great horror film. I'm going to go ahead and say that whenever I went to go see the movie tonight and I'm sitting there waiting in line, all of a sudden I look to my right, Michael Myers was literally standing there. I got a really cool picture with him. It was fucking great. Once again, Scott 86, Halloween 2018, You guys, definitely go check it out. It was by far one of the best sequels of the franchise. So, until next time, Scott 86, Monster Mash, I'll see y'all in the next episode.